since.
Have you received any other vaccine in the past 2 days?
No.
Have you had COVID before or no? Have you been hospitalized because of COVID or any other?
No.
Some more?
Have you ever
been hospitalized?
Yeah. Never been hospitalized for?
30 years.
30 years, okay, good. Have you ever felt faint or fainted after a vaccination or a flu vaccine or anything?
I've only had one vaccination in my life.
Okay.
Next step. Touch on a few things and ins and outs of what to look for and all that.
Exactly. So you can use an aftercare sheet once you sit over there. But a few things to let you know is it is a two-dose series of the vaccine. So you can first dose today. Well, we're looking at now 42 to 49 days later. That's kind of the new guidelines. 42 days. So, and then you get the second dose. So after your first dose today, your immune system to hold your report, you're going to have about 70% protection against COVID. After the second dose, that's going to take about 95%. At this point in time, there's not enough research or trials to show if this fuel vaccine that we're going to require or okay. So just bear that in mind. It could end up being like a flu shot.
Yeah, I'm sort of familiar with, I mean, a lot of that part of the recall, but I never went to the site to. I mean, I've been in contact with them in Rohan and,
right.
And then gone over a lot of the procedures.
So just some of the common side effects you're going to see. And most likely, and almost guaranteed, you're going to get a very sore arm. Similar to the flu shot on the label, this is we advise that you choose whichever arm that you either don't sleep on heavily or that you don't use as much. However, you should continue to use your arm as normal so that the pain doesn't get too bad and you don't stiffen up. Some of the other common side effects are the redness of the site, a little bit of swelling, and even some swelling under your arm and the the other common side effect is going to be a mild fever, and that can last for tonight and tomorrow. You might feel very, very tired. You might feel a bit achy, chilled, or what comes with the fever. There's no virus used to make the vaccine, so you're not actually going to contract any form of coronavirus. It's your immune system working that causes your body temperature to increase. So those are all normal side effects. What's not normal? If any redness extends below your elbow or starts to spread into your chest or kind of up your side of your neck or anything like that, then you would advise you to talk to one of the nurses or your doctor. Okay, we'll ask that you stay here for 15 minutes afterwards to monitor you for any immediate kind of side effect. And do you have any questions for me?
I've had one, like I said, I've had one vaccination, but I'm in with SARS-H1N.
Yeah, that's
way back when, and my kids convinced me to have that. That's the only, I don't take, I mean, flu shots or any of those.
Oh, you don't do those? Okay.
So this is just the first step, and like I said, forever since I've been there too.
Okay, well thank you for coming then. It's been great, you know, this is our first step as well to get rid of this. Maybe I'll get rid of it, get on top of this virus. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly go through this, so no allergies. Okay, that was pretty straightforward. Do you have any questions at all for me?
Get on with the program.
All right.
I think this is sort of like the first step and a little bit of normality coming back to life, I mean, as we've known it over the last year. Right?
Yeah. Are we going left or right?
Protected.
Oh, sorry, my shirt's getting tattered over. Thanks, Christine. Thank you. Thank you. Nice big band-aids. So we're gonna see if we can leave them.
I'm sure I'll get over it.
Everything's good, no side effects, moving on. A little closer to some sort of normality with at Hitac. Thank you.